of you. I've taught most of you last year, which is brilliant. Those people that don't know me, my name is Mr. Tinney, and I teach geography and also some social studies. Have you guys had the rotation with Mr. Tate?
No.
And year 10? So you've had the history and the social studies, is that right? So the third part of that rotation is 13 or 14 weeks of year 10 geography with Mr. Tate, to give you a little bit of a taster in terms of what geography is about. So in the next 2 or 3 minutes, I'll try and tell you what it is about, a little bit about the topics, in terms of the credits, internals, externals, and any questions that you might have. So geography is the study of anything that nature does and anything that people do and the interaction between the two. So for example, there's an earthquake, geographers look at, you know, what actually is it within the earth that causes earthquakes to occur. We also then have people on the surface of the earth, they build structures like buildings, bridges, roads, etc. And obviously the interaction is where an earthquake occurs near to a place like that, for example Christchurch. And geographers look at not only what causes the earthquakes, but once the earthquake has happened, how has that impacted on people, the structures that they have built, the rock falls that occurred, the liquefaction that occurred, and anything relevant to the Christchurch earthquake. So that's one of the topics next year. It's probably my favourite topic, learning about earthquakes, with specific reference to the September 2010 Canterbury earthquake and the February 2011 earthquake. Some of the other topics we look at, in Term 1 we do an internal assessment looking at the weather. So what we do is you guys will build your own weather station, and we go out of the class on a daily basis and we collect our own information on wind direction, wind speed, rainfall, temperature, and cloud cover, and we learn about what that information is actually telling us about the weather. We compare that information to official statistics from sites like the Met Service and so on. So that's also a topic that I quite enjoyed this year. But another topic, looking at coffee. So geography is quite broad, you know, we can look at so many different things. So we look at, you know, whereabouts in the world is coffee grown? What types of areas are suitable for growing coffee? Which countries in the world drink the most coffee? New Zealand is actually quite high up there in terms of number of cups of coffee per person per year. And we go to the food room, and I make all of the students a shot of coffee, plunger coffee, an instant coffee, and I encourage you to sample the different types of coffee, simply to you know, give you a bit of an awareness around what the different types are like. Sustainability is another topic that we'll look at next year, a bit of a buzzword at the moment. We look at how tourism operates in a small island group called the Maldives, and we look at how tourist operators in that area are trying to operate in a very sustainable way, so that the environment there, it's a very fragile environment, the average height above sea level is about 1.5 metres, so that in 50 years time, in 100 years time, that fragile environment that still exists in the same state that it is today, if not better. So really, really broad. I talked about the earthquakes. Did I talk about the split between internal and external credits?
No.
So you have 4 internal assessments throughout the year. That's a total of 13 credits. And you have 2 exams at the end of the year with 4 credits each. So 13 and 8, that's 21 in total, which is pretty standard across most Level 1 subjects. Any questions? Yeah.
What jobs can you do?
They always ask about jobs. Well, you can go on and even study geography or geology. It branches off at university. You can do physical geography or you can do human geography. And I've written down, you can look at, you can get into the tourism industry. So there's a whole variety of jobs in the tourism industry. You can look at town planning, okay, and Christchurch at the moment is planning to rebuild their township. So geographers are involved in the planning of what the new buildings and the layout will look like. You can get involved in looking at the climate or weather, transport, anything to do with the environment, emergency management, hazards. So New Zealand, we've got volcanic eruptions, earthquakes, we've got floods and droughts. You can get involved in working for an insurance company, looking at areas of risk. Resource consent, you could work for the Department of Conservation. You could be a land surveyor. So, you know, it's a really broad subject that gives you so many options in terms of where you want your career to go to. And the last thing I'll say is that what I said to the other class was a little bit of a challenge. It's the sort of thing that I challenge you guys to take for at least a year to try, because it's the sort of subject that if you don't like it, you can drop it at the end of year 11 and you can look at alternatives. But once you do try it for a year, 99% sure that you would enjoy the subject so much that you would carry it on. So try it for a year. Come and see what Year 11 Geography is all about. And if you don't like it, you can always drop it at the end and take something else in the book too. Okay, guys, there's people waiting. Thanks for your time.